was up where we wanted it.
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the 2015 Party in the House for South Delta Minor Hockey Association. Our pleasure to bring you the call for not only the Atom game, which is up first, but also the Pee-wee, the Bantam, and the Midget final game. We will be on air for each game, following each game on the webcast. We will close down and log back on for the next game. So there's not going to be two games simultaneously scheduled back-to-back, only in the ice allocation. Our pleasure to bring you the call for today's game. Steve Erickson, Bruce Nolte on camera. Our pleasure to do this for you. Of course, it's that time of the year where all the young boys and girls are out showing their talents, and who knows, the next superstar coming for the National Hockey League might be playing in one of the games that we focus and headline today for your viewing pleasure. We talked about the teams, the way minor hockey has grown. South Delta Minor Hockey has been very fortunate over the last number of years to put a large number and a very prominent group of individuals to play in the National Hockey League. We have been indeed fortunate to have the Stanley Cup come to Delta several different occasions, primarily with the success for young Mr. Brent Seabrook, who has showing his talent levels at a high level in the National Hockey League, playing with the Chicago Blackhawks, as well as when Troy Brower was with the Chicago Blackhawks organization. Troy coming from the North Delta Minor Hockey Association. So on the one season, it's ironic that not only did we have the Stanley Cup come to South Delta, we had it go to the North Delta area the following day, something that not a lot of individuals can and have had the luxury of making mention of. Of course, not only just Troy Brower, Brent Seabrook, a young superstar in his own right now, a young man from the South Delta area, made his way through the minor hockey, originally from the Edmonton area, and his father is the trainer, the conditioning coach for the Vancouver Giants to play out of this facility for the Western Hockey League. Special shout out to Brendan Batchelor with the Vancouver Giants, the play-by-play voice. Of course, Who else would we be talking about? Mr. Brendan Gallagher, a very, very indeed young superstar. We will start our Adam final game, and it's off right now. The North Delta, or the, pardon me, the South Delta squad come in. They go deep against the line, waiting for it. And the home team will be the Screaming Eagles, from what we have been told. Waiting for it all the way back up the center. Waits, looks straight down. Inside the corner, holding on to that one. Roberts had it and then dumped it back. Now we'll go the other way, across the line. Straight inside the corner, going deep to the goal line. Nice shot taken by DeBoer. He kicked that one wide, and that goes inside, past the young sprawling goaltender to get one of the board. And that is going to make everyone thrilled on the bench. He goes over, they high-five each other. And it's interesting to watch the young players at this age, despite the fact that all the controversy and the success that players have once they get to the National Hockey League level and possibly on the world stage, such as the World Junior Championships going on right now. The interesting part is these young boys and girls that are playing this game, it's just a world of smiles from start to finish. That's all they have. So the guest team scored first on the board. They have an early lead. Now we'll go straight down across the blue line, holding on to it. Knobs had it, then lost it. Now goes back inside the zone once again. Waits, nice cross-ice pass, dumping it all the way back down. We go in, but they're offside by about a stride and a half. Jack Dosenberg was the one in control of the puck. There was an offside delayed right there. So wherever your travels take you, hope you enjoy the broadcast. Coming to you today from the Ladner Leisure Center, working with South Delta Minor Hockey Association. We'll mention our game sponsor, First Chance We Can. Across the line, this time on the far left side, Alan Cushing has it, looks against the wall. Nice play to pick this one back up. Dowler has it. He fights for it against the wall, and they couldn't get control of it to get the shot on goal. Now they pick it back up on the far side wall this time, waiting for it. They just dump it inside deep by the corner. Throw it back out to the blue line. Stopped, intercepted. We're trying to get the rosters correct because there's a couple of numbers on my roster that one is crossed out. So I'm just trying to get it correct because according to the scoreboard, we have the guest team scoring first. So we'll make sure that everything is in proper proximity as to what they are. The Knights are the away team. They're the black team on the ice tonight. So have a line change right now. Players coming onto the ice. Players stepping on the ice. Kupolis steps onto the ice. And while we're waiting for the line change, welcome our first period game sponsor today. It's brought to you by Lawn Lift. Save the water you drink for your drinking and not sprinkly and paint your lawns. Eco-friendly, pet and kid safe. Great for touching up your dog spots or brown cedar trees. There's a New Year's special. You can get two bottles for the ready spray for $49.99. Give it lawnlift.ca, our first period game sponsor for the party in the house. Over against the wall, this time over on the left side. Komal has it, looks, takes it deep behind the goal line, far side. Picking up back up is Hoffman. He has it at the blue line, dumped it, blocked and intercepted back in by Westering. He had control of it, now just throws it back around again, and they're pushing forward over against the wall, this time on the far left side, taking it deep behind the goal line, pinching back in, looks, waits, failed to get control of this one. Kupolis was the one that stepped inside, failed to get control. Now they go back the other way. It goes as far as the blue line. That's as far as that play materialized. Now they come in the other side. Pratt has it, goes against it, deep against the wall, forced him off of it. Is DeBoer, waits, looks, back out to the blue line. Long shot taken, picked up just inside the blue line by about 40 feet. Now he had control of it, looks, shot it back, waiting for it. In control of it still. Now they get it all the way back out to the center ice area. Blocked and turned. Now they're going to go back the other way. Straight down. DeBoer has control. Overskated the puck as it goes inside the blue line. Tagging up at the line to get onside. Good call by the young official in today's game. Can't say their names. I'm not sure who they are. Nobody's given us their names. So our apologies. We will find that out. We'll do our best to see if we can get their names as best we can. Stopped. 30 feet inside over on the far side this time. Now the Screaming Eagles pick it back up and they go the other way. Straight down, going across the blue line. Lost it, misplayed the puck, but they're offside. One extra stride right there. Lost his footing as he got to the blue line. Carson Kupolis lost his footing and fell down. And we'll go back out, have a face-off out in the neutral zone, this time over on the far side. Good amount of fans come out to take the game in today in the Ladner Leisure Center. Welcome everybody on board. Hope everyone's enjoying the broadcast on the World Wide Web. You can follow us on Twitter. It's just simple. It's at Sportswave for Twitter. And you can send me a note on Twitter. Let us know that you're watching the game, where you might be watching the game from. And we'll make mention, give a shout-out to you and your family or your community in which you might call home. Straight down, waiting for it, holding on to this one. Knobs has it, goes up the center. Knobs dumped this one back over to Ryan Roberts, and he throws it inside against the wall. Far side, waiting for it. The Knights pick it back up, trying to clear it back out. Waits once again. Knobs still pushing for it. He failed to get it. Now it goes back over in front of the boards and the bench over on the players' bench side. They get up and over the blue line. This time throwing it straight inside. Dosenberg has control, dumps it deep against the goal line as Dosenberg goes inside. Waits. Buchanan comes inside. He tries to pick it back up and clear it. And it's still against the boards. 10:45 left. First period of play. Out to the center ice area. Across the line. Now they dump it clearly up to the center area once again. McConnell goes inside. He has it. Looks. Goes deep towards the net. Takes a shot. That was blocked right on goal. Big save. And they kick that one all the way back out to the ring end line. And they have control of it. Knobs has it. Clears it, blocked, intercepted. Knobs gets it back over on the ringette side on the far side once again, and they clear it back out again to Dowler, and he just dumps it inside the zone once he gets over center. A line change coming up for both defensive players as they come on. Kupolis comes on the ice as well as I'm trying to look. I think it's the number 18. It is. Battia is number 18. Perry Battia, double-checking our game notes to make sure we've got the rosters on the correct side. Waits, looks, easily played, and the Knights clear it all the way out of their own zone up the center. Straight down, across the blue line. Dosenberg comes inside, threw it inside. Now he has to go back and pick it back up. Lost it. Caldicott looks. He gets over the blue line. Now they cut back inside once again. Going over on the far side wall is McConnell. He gets pushed off of the puck. Centers it back out, though. Still got the shot away, regardless, and he managed to do so. Caldicott had it, looks, they get bumped off the puck in front of the penalty box. No call on the play by the officials. Whoops, a couple players colliding out there. Nothing called on the play, nothing really warranted to be called. Both players just colliding. Neither one saw where each other was going to be going. All the way over on the far side this time. Cleared it out to the blue line. That's as far as they got that pass back, and now they go the other way. Over on the far left side, cutting towards the front part of the net was Pratt. Had the puck roll off of his stick, and it goes back out to the center ice area. 9 minutes left, first period of play. Waiting for it. Screaming Eagles get out of their own zone in front of their own players' bench this time. Good play by Battia, and he got it out of his own zone. Now it goes back inside, and they turn inside the corner. Kupolis has control of it, takes it directly behind his own net, holding onto it, shoots it against the boards, over on the far side. Alan Cushing has control, just cleared it down the ice. Icing is waved off, not going to make that, just a little bit slow. The puck, not the players. Don't get me wrong on that. The players are having a field day out here. This is a lot of fun coming out and covering the games here. We have a penalty coming up. Delayed penalty called right now. And this will go against a tripping minor penalty. Going against the black team, the South Delta Knights. Always interesting to watch the players' reaction at this level when they get a minor penalty assessed to them. They get the minor penalty called, and not only it's fun to watch the young minor hockey players with the penalty call, it's interesting to watch... having a bit of a discussion. Maybe someone else is going to be going in the box. Oh, the coach picked the right player. That's where the referee got one. The coach got another one. So at least they put some in the box. It was a good call. Nice penalty call on the play. So we'll wait. The penalty that's listed on the clock is listed to number 16, Cameron White, according to our roster. We'll wait for the official announcement. And from the draw, goes inside the zone, holding on to it, clears it all the way back out to center, intercepted easily right there by Buchanan. He gets control of it and dumps it back out to Westering. He gets across the line, throws it back down. Nice play getting it over on the far left side. There's Noyers. He had control. Now it goes out to the blue line once again. Knobs has it. Looks and it goes the other way right now. They pick it up and dump it inside the zone, holding on to it, taking it off of the puck easily right there, but good forechecking by Moy as he got the shot deep to the goal line. Now they turn and go the other way. Picking it back up is Westering. He has control. Over on the far right side this time. Just throws it off of the wall. Comal goes after this one for the Knights. Clears it. Not out. They're still shorthanded by a minute and 15 seconds on the power play for the Screaming Eagles. Forechecking, doing a good job fighting for the puck, trying to pick it back up, but they clear it as far as the blue line. Got control, but it was Bob Buchanan. Then it rolled off of his stick. Now the Knights will go the other way, across the blue line, cutting inside. Misplayed that one, and the Eagles go straight down. They are flying across the line, going in is Knobs. Knobs goes deep to the goal line, shot. Oh, nice play, and a well-played stop by Ryland, the young goaltender, to direct that one behind the net. Shot off of the backboard, trying to pick it back up is DeBoer. He has control, then he just cleared it around. But it was misplayed by Desnoyers, and he couldn't get his stick on it. Funny little passing play. No one could get control of that one. Now it goes off of the back wall. Picked back up. Waits. A long stretch pass all the way down the ice. Icing is waved off as they're still killing this minor penalty with 30 seconds left in the minor penalty. Holding onto it. Out to the blue line area, and they got control, dumped it back in with 20 seconds left in the power play for the Screaming Eagles. Deep against the goal line, going inside is Dozenberg. He has it behind the goal line. Centers, tries to get it all the way back out in front to Campbell. It was just off the heel of Campbell's stick, and 5 seconds remain in the minor penalty as he gets set to stand up. And I'm not sure whether anyone's told him to come out on the ice right now because the minor penalty has expired. And now they told him he can come back on the ice probably about maybe 15 seconds after it expired. But he's back on the ice. He's coming back over to the players' bench for a line change. It's always a long time when you're in the penalty box. That 2 minutes when you're in there sitting in the sin bin, he seems to go so slow. Believe me, I've been there a lot of times. I was no angel when I played. But I played. Nonetheless, I had a lot of fun, and I had a lot of great coaches and a lot of memories coming out of the minor hockey situation and the coaching staff that were involved in our program. Straight down across the line, this time over on the far side. Waits, Pratt takes a shot. Snap! Nice save right there, going wide, holding onto it. And man, oh man, what an exceptional save to pull that one on. Just a miraculous stop. Completely saw that with 5:40 left. They made it look stop and made it look easy. So face-off deep inside the corner. This time it'll be over on the right of young Max Ryland, lining things up. South Delta Knights have an early lead in the game. They take a 1-0 lead so far. Now they come out of their own zone all the way out to the blue line area, getting straight back up the center ice area. Knobs goes after that one. He bumps with his man. The two players collide. No penalty on the play. Coaching staff thought there might have been, but the referees obviously thought otherwise. Deep inside the corner, Knobs goes in. Centering pass, big save. The rebound going after that one. They scramble at it to try and get control of it. Brendan Little has it. Clears it to the blue line. Good forward pass, getting it straight up to McConnell, and he chases this one back down at center ice area. Far side. Now we have the Knights come back the other way. They go inside across the blue line, trailing right there was Buchanan. He tries to get it and get it away from his stick. Failed to do it. Now the Knights continue to press all the way back out in front, right on goal. Dozenberg goes in, takes a shot, rolls wide of the net. 4:55 left in this first period of play, and it goes on the back of the net. So we have a quick stoppage of play and a faceoff once again inside the zone. This time it will be to the right of young Max Ryland, the goaltender that's playing between the pipes today for the Knights. Oh, correction, the Screaming Eagles. And the goaltender for the Screaming Eagles, as we look at it, trying to make sure we get the roster correct. The goaltender, Bryson Rabane, is the goaltender playing for the Eagles. Now we've got a line change. Six on the ice doesn't count it, so they're setting one off. So now they've got five, the proper number. Waits, a long shot, taken just rolls wide of the goal, over in the corner, this time over on the right side wall, easily picked up, kept onside once again by DeBoer. He just throws it back behind the goal line, and that was intercepted by Kupolis, and he comes over on the right side. Waits, misplayed this one, couldn't get control of it. Once again they go, and DeBoer picks this one back up. DeBoer pushes with Pratt. The two of them both were just chasing after the puck. Neither one got it. Now it goes out to the blue line, kept onside by Comal, and he dumps it over on the far sideboards, and White picks it up. White goes in. White bumps against the wall over on the far side with Battia. The two of them pushed each other only because they were fighting for the puck. Neither one could get control of it. Now they have it on the far side once again. Darian Moy has it. in front of the penalty box area. Nice forward pass by Darian Moy to throw that one straight down as they cut back in front. Looks, DeBerg goes in, takes a back end, scores! And DeBerg gets the goal credit right there. But what a nice setup pass over on the far side as they dump that one in. And that will put them up by a 2-0 score with 3:59 left in this first period of play. Both young goaltender, Bryson Robain, as well as Max Ryland, wearing number one for the Knights and the Screaming Eagles. Both goaltenders made a couple of impressive stops so far. Going in across the blue line, over on the right side, Dowler has it. Dowler does the centering pass, and that was intercepted by the Knights, and they come the other way. Going straight down across the line, Hoffman comes inside, throws it over on the far left side to Dosenberg. Dosenberg bumps in the corner, centering pass out in front, right in the blue paint, and a dangerous move right there, but Robain made an exceptional stop to stop that one. Knobs comes down across the line, he goes deep, he goes on the left side, cuts back inside. Knobs lost his footing, fell down, coming in to help out was Caldicote. He has control of it. Now they cleared it the other way, and it goes back up the ice all the way out to the blue line. Play carries on. No stoppage of play. No penalty called in the play. None warranted so far, except the one that the referee did call earlier on. Across the line, over on the far left side. Coming inside, easily picked this one back up was Dosenberg. He does a centering pass, but it goes out to the blue line, past everybody, and down the ice. They're going to have a bit of a foot race. Everybody's chasing after this one. Dowler goes in, tries to get control of it. Dowler couldn't get control. Cuttercoat took it off of him, and now they center it all the way back out to the blue line once again. Kupolis comes inside, keeps it on side of the blue line, dumped it back inside the corner. This time it goes over on the left side wall, but it was offside, called by the young referee, said it was offside by about a stride and a half. Not going to work. So they will have a quick stoppage of play. And once again, a reminder that our first period is brought to you today by Lawn Lift. Save the water for drinking, not sprinkling, and paint your lawns. Eco-friendly, pet and kid safe. Great for touching up your dog spots or brown cedar trees. New Year's special for South Delta Minor hockey families. Two bottles of our Ready Spray for $49.99. Give them a call or visit them at lawnlift.ca. Far side waiting for it. Nice play as the Knights come in. Tried the centering pass. Couldn't get the shot right on goal. Misplayed it. Now Kupolis gets all the way out of his own zone. Up the center. He goes down on the left side. He has Marshall trailing with him. Marshall was cutting towards the front part of the net. Waiting for the pass. Didn't get to him. Now goes out to the blue line. Over on the far set. The batty in. He failed to keep it onside. Goes the other way. Across the blue line. Coming inside. Pushing his man off of the puck. Nice play right there by Pratt to stay with the attacking forward. Now we have a penalty called this time by the referee, and I believe a tripping penalty called by the young referee, and this one's going to be assessed, I believe, to Richard Pratt, who will go to the penalty box for 2 minutes. I mentioned how it's interesting to watch the young players when they're learning at this level. It's also, especially for myself, who has had the luxury of, yes, refereeing forever and an eternity. Actually, just finished my 62nd year referee in ice hockey, and I've had an absolute ball doing them. So I'm not 14 years old no more, just if anybody was questioning and asking that. But the interesting part about this was, it's neat watching these young officials, how they develop their talents and learn at the young age to advance to the next level of success. We've had a lot of them come out of the Delta area to go on and do the junior hockey. From the draw, it goes all the way back out to the neutral zone, back around, intercepted easily right there by Knobs, and he gets it inside the zone. Chasing it back down, pushed off the puck behind the goal line, slow to get up. Referee's watching him. Now we have a stoppage of play. We do. We have a whistle and a stoppage of play. Possible an injury right there. So we'll just take a look at the injury right there over on the far corner. The referee will move in. Check that out. Coach's staff come on the ice to take care of the young players. Head coach for the Screaming Eagles, Greg Knobs, Murray Pratt, Greg Dowler, and the other assistant coach is Alan Marshall. So as the coaching staff come back down, the coaching staff are going to go on the ice, and the players come off of the ice. So a face-off probably back in the corner. The referees are trying to sort this out. The faceoff in this case. Coaching staff questioning the faceoff. So there's always a learning curve. Everyone has to learn. We all know about that. From the draw, it goes all the way back over. This time on the left side wall. Everyone's picking it up. They're all pushing, going deep against the boards, chasing it back down over on the far side. This time is Darian Moy. He has control. Gets out to his own blue line. All the way up the center. Dumps it inside the corner. Going after that is Dozenberg. He failed to get control of it. He pushes himself off of the puck, and that was easily intercepted right there by Kupolis, who comes out the right side this time. All the way out to the blue line area. Stopped. Kept on side. Dumped back inside by Westbrook, and he just got it dumped back in from the blue line. Nice dump in by the young man to keep it onside. Now the play goes the other way, all the way out to the blue line, inside the Knights end zone this time, and they just threw it around the boards, taking it directly behind the net, holding on to that one. Centering pass, back out, and the Knights slow to come out of their own zone, but they got it to the blue line as far as they went this time. Carson Kupolis stepping onside at the blue line over on the left side, stopped at center right there by Perry Battia. Now we go back the other way inside. Hoffman goes in, takes a shot. Nice save right there by Rebane. And Hoffman got the shot away. Now it goes on the far side. The young goaltender, Bryson Rebane, has to get back up and get in his crease. He was probably about 20 feet out of the net after he slid wide of the goal. Straight down the other way, holding on to this one. Waits, picking it back up and slow to come up to the center ice area. They finally do. They got it across the line. Kupolis comes inside. This time goes deep over on the left side wall. Waits for it, holding on to it. Tries a centering pass. Also coming in to help out his Westering. Couldn't get control of it. Now they go the other way across the blue line. Inside, DeBurr comes in, takes a shot. Save! Nice stop by the young goaltender. Rebane holding on to that one. And I'm not sure whether it goes in or not. There was a bit of a scramble. Both referees in there. Now they're going to wave it off. And the period goes. The buzzer goes to end the first period. The players are going to the official and talking to it. I'm not sure whether they're going to go in or it's not going to go in, or count or not count. I see the two officials having a discussion over on the far side. They're both talking to each other right there, checking things out. They're having a bit of a discussion because the one referee was right beside the net, and he basically indicated that he thought it went in. The other referee, I'm not sure whether they're going to indicate, yes, this is a goal or not. It's not. I'm seeing, so they're going to have a discussion and they will talk things over in the penalty box. So maybe we can just get a shot of the players' bench here, Bruce, just down below our broadcast location. Either one, it doesn't matter whether it's the home team or the guest team. Whatever one you want to pick and choose, that's your decision right there. Just to mention also some additional notes that we were passed is that when you talk about Laundliff, our first period sponsor, their son Carson Lundy plays for the Adam C team and narrowly missed playing in today's final game. Oh, you are so missed. Always nice to come out and take part in this. Special hello and shout out to Carson Lundy. The Party in the House committee would like to thank Nicola and Craig Lundy for donating all of their post-game snacks for this year's tournaments. Well, that's always fun for everybody. I know it's a good time. Never mind the young boys and girls that are playing the game. The timekeepers enjoy the snacks as well, and so do the referees. They've told me that they enjoy it and they have fun coming out and taking part in the game. So there's still 1 second left in the minor penalty on the clock, so they will wait. They'll drop the puck. We'll get another player coming out of the box right now. I'm waiting to see if we're going to get one more player out of the on the ice. Oh, now they come. They had 5-on-3, then it was 4-on-3, now it's 5-on-5. So eventually we got things worked out and everything is solved. Back down, taking it behind the goal line, holding on to this one, easily picked up by the Knights as the Knights pick it back up and slow to come out of their own zone. Waits in front of the player's bench for the Screaming Eagles. They go straight down, up the center, going in across the goal blue line. Now they cut back to the net. Going after that one is McConnell. Looks, taking a shot. Nice stop right there by Rebane as he got that one off the top part of his left shoulder. Again, taking a shot. Referee, one is there, one is not. The one referee, the one that was at the blue line, saw it go in over on the far side. So now they're going to say, yes, it was a goal. Indecision once again for the two officials, but they're sorting it out. They're doing a good job. All they have to do is go to the center ice, drop the puck, go to the penalty box, report the penalty, and we'll wait. So obviously that's going to be another goal that will go up on the clock. So that will put them up a 3-0 lead right now. I'm not sure whether they're giving the official announcement on that one or not. We get to our second period sponsor, first opportunity we can. And from the draw, goes all the way back inside the corner, holding on to this one, easily played and picked up. Now just dumped back out to center and go across the line over on the far side by Brendan Little. He goes in, takes the shot, that rolled wide. DeBoer couldn't put his stick on that one. Going in, just shot wide of the target right there. Neither one managed to get control of it. Now they go back the other way, and the Knights get control. The Knights this period are going from your right to your left. Waits over on the right side wall this time. Pratt has control. He lost his footing. Two of them collided. Neither one was hurt. Now they pick it back up, and DeBoer has control. Clears it out to the blue line area a little, but we have a body-checking penalty called by the referee this time. So the referee has a body-checking penalty. I didn't see it, so I can't even question that or discuss it. So the one that's going back to the penalty box this time will be Richard Pratt for the 2 minutes for a body-checking penalty. So while we're waiting for them to get things sorted out, they can make mention that the second period for today's game is brought to you by your Dollar Store and More. Your Dollar Store and More in Tawasin Town Center, serving South Delta community since 2003 and a proud member of South Delta Minor Hockey. And their son, Carson Kupelis, is playing in today's game for the home team, the Screaming Eagles. He wears number 7. We mentioned his name a couple of different times. And, of course, the Party in the House committee want to thank Wayne Kupelis and your Dollar Store for More for donating the NHL stickers and sticker book for every Adam participant in this year's event. Thank you very much for your Dollar Store in Tawasin. Nice to have a sponsor on board that's local, that's been around since 2003. So the faceoff is over on the far side this time. Over on the right side of Max Ryland. All the way back out to the middle from the draw. Now they will come the other way, and the Knights get out of their own zone all the way up the center. Nice play. Westbrook goes straight down, gets a shot. Oh, just rolled wide of the outside left post. But what a nice shot by Ryland Westbrook as he got that shot well placed within inches of going in. Far side, dumping it out to the center ice. Allen Crushing goes down, gets control across the blue line. Of course, the Eagles are shorthanded for a minor penalty called by the referee for tripping. Back the other way. They still work it out. And the Knights come back the other way, thrown over on the far side to Dosenberg. He dumps it back out to the blue line area, blocked and kept onside by Connor Hoffman, who throws it out to the blue line once again to Westbrook. He just clears it over. Far left side, getting control of Allen Crushing. He throws it out to center, then goes after it and chases it himself. Nice forward pass to throw that one straight inside the zone after they give it over to Roberts, this time over on the right side. Waits. And they're slow to come back the other way, but the Knights get down to their own zone. Back down, 45 seconds left in the power play for the South Delta Knights. And the Knights are on a wholesale line change. They're pressing inside, trying to get some extra shots on goal. They're up by 3-0 right now. 35 seconds left in the power play. Off of the backboards, holding on to this one. The two of them are pushing against the wall this time. Neither one could pick it back up. And it goes the other way. Far side wall. Going after it. Waits. Now they'll come back out to center ice area. Now they go the other way. They're all the way down here at center. And they get across the blue line. Easily played, but the referee calls him offside with 5 seconds left, or four now. It moved one extra second. So 4 seconds left in the minor penalty. That was assessed to number 8, Richard Pratt, for the Screaming Eagles. Pleased to be doing all 4 final games today for the Party in the House for the 2015 South Delta Minor Hockey Association Party in the House. Webcast them last year. A lot of fun, a lot of good comments from the individuals in the area, and it's always fun to come out and take part in the minor hockey programs or the sports in general in the Delta area. Straight down, careful to stay onside the blue line. Good pickup right there by DeBoer as DeBoer just throws it all the way back over. Stopped and blocked in front. Nice play to turn it around, and Battia just cleared it out of harm's way. Back to the front part of the net. Waits, looks, couldn't get control of it. Just a little bit of sweeping motion right there, but Kupelis goes after that one. Across the blue line, they throw it all the way out in front of the goal. Easily picked up by the Knights once again. They just dump it down the ice. Is icing indicated? I'm not really sure whether icing is indicated or not. And it was, and it was finally called. So we have an icing call back, and the faceoff will be back down inside the zone once again. So that's always a good portion right there. As we watch them, the players coming back out in the line change, waiting to set things up. So once they set things up, we'll get them all going. So faceoff's back inside the corner. From the draw, we go all the way back out to the blue line area. Kept right, oh, just rolled wide of the target. Good play to pick this one back up, and Stansfield goes after it. Couldn't put his stick on it. 10:52 left in this second period of play. 3-0 for the Lights across the blue line. Cutting back to the inside. Nice play. Chasing this one back down is McConnell. Rolled off of the heel of his stick, and it goes wide of the net. Waits. Back out to the blue line area. Nice play to dump it back to the middle part of the ice. However, they couldn't materialize a setup pass right there, but White dumps it back in from the blue line. Off of the back wall, picked back up. They just clear it back around, holding onto it, shooting it around, trying to get control. McConnell pinches back in, as does Dosenberg. Both of them takes the shot, put it in. I think Dosenberg's going to get credit with that goal. So we'll wait. The referees go over and make the announcement of the goal. So from the draw, it goes all the way back out. So they're up by four right now. The South Delta Knights are up, taking a 4-0 lead in the contest right now. Now it goes back the other way, over against the wall, deep inside the corner, chasing it back down, trying to clear it out of their own zone. After that is Westering, and he just gets it all the way back out to the blue line area. Nice play to pick up some valuable speed. Straight down across the line, going inside, swinging after this one was Desnoyers, and he couldn't put his stick on. Just a little bit out of his reach. Now they go the other way, back inside the blue line, this time on the left side. McConnell goes after it, put his stick down. Again, out of his reach. It's outside the neutral zone, so they have to tag up to get back on side. Codicott goes in. He dumped it back inside. Everybody's tagging up at the blue line right now. Now they finally work it out of their own zone for the Screaming Eagles. Straight down across the blue line, throwing it right on goal. Save. Big rebound given right there, but it's off the top part of the glass. Deflected a little bit wide, and it gets to the blue line. Kept on side. Then they get it back out again. A little bit of a swing and a miss, baseball style, as if they were going to be playing for the Vancouver Canadiens in the single A ball. The farm team for the Toronto Blue Jays in the area. We're lucky to have them here. Across the line, going inside. Nice play as Kinley DeBoer goes inside. Had the puck taken off of his stick, but he continues to press inside and fight for it. Buchanan goes after that one. Both of them pushed for it. Neither one got it. Out to the blue line once again, holding on to this one. Westbro dumped it back in from the point, holding onto it and chasing it back down. Roberts goes after that. They're all pushing for it, waiting. Out to the blue line, kept onside once again by DeBoer, and he just got it straight over on the far side to Como this time. Como pinches back in, takes the shot. The rebound going after that is Campbell. Campbell put his stick on it, just rolled wide of his stick, and DeBoer comes back in from the blue line to try and get control of this one once again. Shot, misplayed it, trying to get it back out. Couldn't, kept it onside. Como goes in, had a roll off of his stick, and now we'll go the other way with Roberts getting a wide open break, this time down the left side. Roberts comes inside, goes straight down, takes a shot, rolls just inches wide of the outside of the post. Kept onside again, and they're still striving to get control of it. Out of their own zone, but it was kept onside of the blue line. Nice play to keep it onside by Kupolis, but it goes back the other way regardless. Straight down, DeBoer goes after this one, waits across the blue line, far left side this time. Centering pass all the way out in front, and they just dumped it back in from the blue line over on the left side by Jonah Kummel, and now we'll come the other way. Home team, the Screaming Eagles, trying to get one on the board. Get them within a little bit, catching up action for what they were telling us earlier on. They don't want to get behind too much. And of course, it's not out of reach for anyone yet. Straight down across the line the other way. Deep inside the corner, going after that one is Carson Kupolis. He takes it behind the goal line, chases it, just does a clearing pass. This time it goes over on the far left side to Alan Cushing, and he gets it out of his zone all the way up to the center line. Slow to get up there, had to take an extra little bit of a stutter step to get there, but he got there regardless. Rolled off of the heel of his stick, a little bit of players push in front of the goal, the blue line area, and both in front of the visitors players bench, but it goes the other way. Straight down, Pratt goes in the corner. He tries to get it, took his man off of the puck. Nice play as Pratt took him down, still in control of it, waiting for it. Far side this time, it's against the wall. pushing inside the corner. Now comes out in the mid part of the ice, and they turn and go the other way. Kupolis gets it out to the blue line. That was blocked and kept onside. Now they'll go back the other way once again, and they still get up the center. Good play to get control. Careful. Referee called him for the onside play. Cuts back inside. Shot scores. Nice goal. And a well-played goal by Richard Pratt. One extra move, and Richard Pratt puts him. We just talked about the fact of how they want to get one on the board and get them within reason. Now the whole team is out there cheering for everybody. That brings a little bit of lively action to the players on the bench and the players on the ice, as well as the coaching staff. I can see the coaching staff down below our broadcast location cheering. Greg Knobs, Murray Pratt. Ellen Marshall and Greg Dowler, I believe it says on our... It does. It says Greg Dowler. And the manager is Leslie Zenoyes. Leslie is the manager that's doing all the work behind the scenes to make the boys and girls have a lot of fun. Collision course right in front of the players' bench right there. Neither one got hurt. That's good for them. Everything is fine as long as no one ends up getting themselves hurt in the game. Leighton Knobs cleared it out. Centering pass in front. Going after this one easily is DeBurr, and he takes it behind the net. DeBurr comes out from behind the goal line this time, holding on to it. Knobs stays with him. Clears it out to the blue line. It's down the ice, so we might have an icing called by the referee. We will see. And we do. On that note, we have an icing call with 6:12 left in the second period of play. 4-1. The South Delta Knights are up by a 4-1 margin. A faceoff will go all the way back down the ice the other way. And while we're watching this right now, I just want to make mention real quick so I get it all right and I don't forget about it. Make mention of our period number two sponsor today. It's your Dollar Spore and More. Your Dollar Store with More in Tawasin Town Center, serving the South Delta community since 2003 and a proud member of the South Delta Minor Hockey Association. The Party in the House committee wants to thank Wayne Kupolis for the sponsorship, as they have donated all the NHL stickers and sticker books for every Adam participant in this year's event. Special thanks to the Dollar Store for sponsorship for the second period for today's game. We ask you to please down and patronize your sponsors coming out. Help the Minor Hockey Association continue to grow and get bigger and better in the area. Off of the wall. This time it goes all the way back down to the center line anyway, and that's as far as that. Battia had it. Clears it over on the far right side. Kupolis goes after this one. He picks it back up, and he just throws it straight forward up to Roberts. He goes down the far left side. Cuts back to the inside. Roberts comes inside. Easily forced off of the puck, but they continue to press deep inside the corner. They're down by three, but we can see, looking in the crystal ball, it wouldn't be one bit surprised if they get one more or a couple more on the board to get it within reason. Kupolis throws it over this time on the far side over to Roberts. Roberts goes in, dumps it back out to the middle, misplayed it, stopped, chasing it back down is Desnoyers. He gets it back, looks, waits, turns, takes his man off of the puck on the far side is Westering, and Westering continues to fight for this one. Now they go back the other way, straight down in front of the players' benches. Coaching calling for line changes, and they all strive to go to the front part of the net. Little goes out in front of the net, but he was all by himself. Nobody was with him this time. Deep off of the back wall, they try and shoot it and clear it all the way out. Didn't have much success in that play right there, but they got it as far as they wanted. Now they go back the other way. Battia comes out this time over on the left side, gets it straight up to the ringhead line. Battia continues to pick up speed, just dumps it straight forward. Now it goes inside the zone and goes inside the corner, waiting for it. They turn, clearing it straight forward. Off of the back wall, couldn't pick it back up as they finally did. Dumped it inside once again. And the Eagles pressing, haven't had luck on their side the last couple of times, but they're still doing a lot of pressing. Waits. Kupolis goes over, this time on the far left side. Alan Crushing goes in. He gets control of the puck. Shot it, misplayed it. Holding on to it, and they still keep it onside, but it's dumped as far as the blue line area. Pratt keeps it onside. Pratt continues to fight inside, goes in, took it off of his right skate, kicked it straight forward. That was intercepted by Campbell, and he got it to the blue line, but that was kept onside again by Knobs. Knobs dumps it inside the corner. Como goes after that one, and he picks it back up. This time he circles behind his own net, off of the back wall, lost it, easily played right there, and Pratt comes in, takes a shot off of the outside post, centers it and tries to jam it in the short side. Is going out is Ryland to stop that sprawling puck as the puck just rolled wide of the target. Couldn't pick it back up. 3:20 left, second period of play. still in control of it. The Knights get out of their own zone, up the center. DeBoer comes straight down, cuts to the middle. DeBoer goes inside, still has control of the puck, takes it this time, has it this time on his backhand, forehand. DeBoer tries a centering pass, gets it all the way out to Campbell as far as he got, off of the outside of the net, trying to pick it back up and have a little bit of help when Hoffman comes inside. Hoffman out in front of the goal, as is Campbell, both of them out there. And now the Eagles come the other way. All the way up the center. Nice forecheck by the Eagles to get straight down onside. And they're going inside to the net. And Alan Crushing goes in the corner. He tries to pick it back up. Gives it over to Pratt. Pratt tries a centering pass off of the backboard. Stolen right there by Komal. Komal couldn't get control. Centering it out in front again. Stopped on the back part of the net. And finally, we have a stoppage of play. And the referee blows the whistle. And we have a faceoff inside the corner. This time it's just over on the left of the young goaltender, Max Ryland, playing goal for the South Delta Knights today. Coming on the ice to take it is Dosenberg, I think, is going to take the draw. His counterpart will be Ryan Roberts. Roberts got it, pulled it out to the blue line area to Battia. He takes a shot. That was blocked and intercepted once again by Dosenberg, and he gets it all the way out to center. He gets forced off of the wall by Kupolis. He had control of it. Wait, stopped, misplayed this one. Now they pick it back up over on the far side, deep inside the corner. Centering pass. Nice play right there, but that was picked up by Battia. And he takes it this time over on the left side. Gets it out to the blue line area. All the way up the center. Straight down. Up to the blue line. They dump it inside the zone. Komal cleared it back out to the blue line. And they tagged up to get onside. Now the offside is nullified, but they still throw it straight up the ice to Moy. And Moy gets it across the center line. Nice play as he gets it straight up. Moy continues to fight after it. Gets it across the line. This time over on the far left side to Roberts. Roberts couldn't clear it up, so it's dumped down the ice regardless. And we could have a possible icing call, and we do. So the faceoff this time will be back inside the zone for the Screaming Eagles. This time it will be, I'm assuming it's going to be on the right side for the Screaming Eagles. All the players going back, hustling back somewhat to get themselves set up for the stoppage of play and a face-off, lining themselves up in the corner as they get themselves worked back up. Coming inside to take the draw easily is Kinley DeBoer. He will line himself up for the Knights. Pushed it straight forward. Tried to get it loose away from his counterpart right there. Misplayed that one. Now it goes deep against the wall, holding onto it. Couldn't get it back down. Far side against the boards. Pushed off of the puck over on the far side. Coaches thought there might have possibly been a penalty on that play, but the referee indicated no. Straight up the center ice area. Going across the blue line is McConnell. Throwing it inside. Now they're going to chase it back down. McConnell will come and pick this one back up. And Little goes to the front part of the net. But he couldn't get control of it. Eagles come the other way. Flying high across the line. Centering pass all the way back out to Dowler. And he goes after that one. Lost it. Dowler continues to press inside the zone. Getting control. All of them cleared the zone to tag up. And the play carries on. Out of their own zone is Kinley DeBoer. DeBoer gets control of it. Waiting for it. Shot it. Back out to the neutral ice area once again. They're chasing it back down as McConnell goes after it a third time. Still have control. DeBoer comes inside, takes a shot. Right on goal. Nice stop right there by Rebane, and he holds on that one for a nice executed save. Coming out and stacking the pads like we know he can do at the best of times. He's played a well-timed game so far. Had a lot of fun. And both goaltenders, whether it's Bryson Rebane or Max Ryland, both goaltenders playing strong and very, very strong and agile between the pipes. Waiting for it. The faceoff was in the corner. Now they get it out to the blue line area. Misplayed that one. And they'll go back the other way. Roberts picks it back up. Gets control. Goes across the blue line. Overskated the puck. And Komal intercepts this one. Roberts gets back on side of the blue line. Turns. Goes after the puck. Failed to get it. Now Robert continues to press inside. And they're pushing after it. Trying to get it back to Westering. It was out of his reach, however. Across the blue line once again is Wiesbrod, and he just dumped it inside the corner, and we have a stoppage because the end of the second period has come to a conclusion. So after two periods of play, the Knights are up by a 4-1 score after two periods of play. Coaching have a bit of a discussion with the players. Over on the far side, we look, we've got the Knights as well as the Screaming Eagles. So we'll see if we can just get a shot of their players' benches to see what they're doing. And then start the third period. All right, we are back to start the third period. We had a little bit of a miscommunication in the number-wise. We finally got it sorted out, and they go back down. Dozenberg comes inside. Careful play to keep it onside. We have number six. Our apologies. We have number six listed as Noah Hettinger, and on the sheet we were given, he is listed as number nine. So every time we got the puck, we couldn't say who the young man was because we weren't sure. Our apologies for that, and it's always nice to make proper communication as to who these players are and what they're doing. So a couple players come together and they a little bit of a discussion right there. Something you very seldom see in the Adam level hockey. A couple players coming together and a little bit of pushing and discussion after the whistle has gone. Something that's clearly not needed in the game at this level anyway. Regardless, they'll go back out. They're going to line themselves up. 14-13 left in this third period of play. 4-1 for the Knights right now. Third period underway by 55 seconds. So we go back against the wall. This time it's over on the right side. Nice play to pick it back up, holding onto it. They clear it as far as the blue line. That's as far as they got in that play, but they're picking it back up and going the other way once again. Roberts comes back down. The Roberts goes inside with Westerring and throws it over to him. Westerring's going to chase this one inside the corner, as is Hettinger, and Hettinger goes after that one. Picked it back up, cleared it against the wall. Far left side this time, holding onto it one more time, and they're still in control of it. Back out to the center line, dumping it inside. And they just keep it onside as they continue to play. We'll make mention of our third period sponsor. First opportunity we can get. Out to center once again, holding on to it. I think we have a glove hand pass or a stoppage, or better yet, we have, well, I shouldn't say better yet, my apologies. We have a player down behind the scene. Murray Pratt, one of the alternate coaches, will come on the ice to look after the young player that's down on the ice and appears to be injured. So make mention of today's third period sponsor is brought to you by Western Canada Screens Limited, manufacturers and distributors of wire mesh and perforated plate products. Perfect for your design and industrial projects. Check us out and online at www.architecturalwire.com, or you can give them a call, 604-520-3073. And we've been mentioned that the Greg Knobs is coaching the home team today for the Screaming Eagles, and his son Leighton Knobs is wearing number 3. So that's Western Canada Screens Limited, period number 3 sponsor. Coaching staff out there taking care of the players. Of course, just a reminder, you can come out to the Ladner Leisure Center each and every Tuesday night, as Delta TV, very pleased to be doing the game of the week this year on Delta TV, Channel 10, each and every Tuesday night, on air at 7:30 p.m. Catch all the action. Delta Ice Hawks, a proud member of the PJHL. And If you want more information, not only on the IceHawks, but how your minor hockey team might be able to get involved and have a between-period game, feel more than free to visit the website. You can visit the Delta IceHawks website and contact the owner, Wes Musio, and send him an email, or Peter Zerbinas, the general manager, and they will put you in touch as to what you have to do to be a part of the intermission for the Delta IceHawks PJHL Game of the Week on Delta TV 10. Far side, line change coming up right now for the Screaming Eagles. The referee is calling the players back out to the ice. Make sure they have everything all listed and set up, and they do. And from that, the referee drops the puck, and it got all the way back over, this time to Alan Crushing, and he throws it inside the zone. Over on the left wall this time, picking it back up out in front of his own player's bench was Carson Kupelis, and he just goes back to pick it up one more time. Still fighting for it. Lost it. Couldn't get control for the second time right there, and Battier just cleared it behind his own net. Far side wall, going after that one is Alan Crushing. He tries to pick it up, centering all the way out in front, and now the Eagles come out of their own zone. Got to the ringette line as far as they managed to do with all that time. Battier goes back to play tough defensively inside his own zone. They have to tag up at their own blue line to get onside. They finally clear it out and got onside. Cameron White got onside. Across the line, careful to get it inside the corner. Chasing it back inside, holding on as that is DeBurr, and DeBurr goes after that one. Stopped at the blue line by Komal. Komal throws it back into DeBurr. DeBurr picks it up, this time over on the far left side. Cuts back to the middle of the ice. Kupelis goes in, takes a shot high over top of the net. Couldn't get that one where he intended it for. And they're still up by a 4-1 lead, 12:15 remaining in this third period of play. Straight down the ice. Richard Pratt goes straight down across the blue line. Cuts back to the middle of the ice. Pratt holds onto it. Throws it over, this time far side. Gets the shot away. Pratt's chasing the rebound down. Neither one could pick it back up. And Dowler's outside of the blue paint in front of the crease waiting for the rebound. Now Dowler's going in the corner trying to get control of this one. DeBurr goes after that one. Fights for it again as well. Shot. Clearing it all the way, but not out, and the Knights having a rough time. They're being hemmed inside their zone right now by the Screaming Eagles. The Eagles doing a great job pressing. Shot right on goal. Big stop by young goaltender Max Ryland, and he made a huge save to keep that one from going in. 11:46 remaining in this third period of play. Coming to you from the Ladner Leisure Center, Steve Erickson, Bruce Nolte, our pleasure to bring you the call for today's game. And all four games today, Adam, Peewee, Bantam, and Midget games, you can visit them. And they will be archived on the sportswave.ca website later on for your viewing pleasure at a later date if you're unable to watch them today. Kept against the boards, this time over on the left side. Knobs goes after it, keeping it on side of the blue line. Now gets control, goes deep against the wall, holding onto it. Knobs get pushed off of the puck, but continues to drive after it, waiting for it. Westering comes inside to go after this one. Lost it, misplayed, roll off the stick of Buchanan, and now the Knights come back the other way. Knights go inside, takes a shot right on goal, big stop, the rebound right there. Dosenberg comes inside, it rolled wide, and they couldn't pick it back up, clearing it all the way out to the blue line. In the neutral ice area, blocked once again. Careful to keep it onside, but they still get control of it, getting inside as McConnell goes to the front part. Shot scores. Nice goal by McConnell as he got one more on the board. And it was a tough play for the Screaming Eagles to clear the puck out of their own zone. They are having a solid game, but just haven't been able to capitalize on the scoreboard so far. They've had their chances, but Max Ryland at the other end of the ice has played exceptional, made a couple of real key saves, as it has their own goaltender, Bryson Rebane, playing between the pipes for the Screaming Eagles. Far side holds onto this one, couldn't get control of it. Now it goes loose, and McConnell picks it back up, just throws it straight forward. Dowler goes after it. Dowler throws it back, but that was blocked and dumped straight down the ice to Little. He comes down. This time goes over on the far left side, but that was blocked again. And Kupelis dumps it all the way back out to the center ice area, straight down against the boards. Going after that one, careful to stay onside. Little comes inside. Little and DeBurr goes inside. Little takes a shot high over top of the net. DeBurr is going to chase this one back down. Waits, looks, couldn't get control of it. Blocked it. They picked it back up. They're coming back inside, and they're doing a good job pressing. And they're hemming in the Eagles right now, but the Eagles, nevertheless, they still materialize to get it back out of their own zone. All the way out to center. Waits across the line, dumping it inside once again with 10:02 remaining in this third period of play. Take it behind the net. Of course, there is medal presentations at the conclusion of this game as well. They get it to the blue line. That's as far as that managed to get. Holding onto it. They're still going inside. They're twisting and turning to get control. And Buchanan cleared it out to the blue line. Kept on side. Buchanan goes after this one a second time. Cleared it. Got it as far as he could to Dowler, and they cleared it out. Dowler is one of the trailers. Now Dowler goes off on a line change, and going inside is Battia. He tried to get it. Battia is on the forward line right now. Was on the defensive line earlier on in the game. Now Battia is coming inside, waiting for it. Looks, holds on to that one. Rolled off of the stick of Kupelis, and he had a solid chance right there. But Max Ryland played that exceptional, read that well. Kept on side, just shot far wide of the boards. Battia is going inside the corner to pick this one back up. Battia cleared it. Called a coat. Cleared it, got it off of his stick. Now they kept it and dumped it back inside, this time off of the back wall, and chasing it back is Desnoyers, and he goes after this one. Waits. Neither one could pick it back up. They shot it off of the boards, over on the left side. Waits. Desnoyers comes back inside once again, and he keeps it on side of the blue line. This time off of the wall, holding on to it as Pratt comes in. He takes a shot. Pratt lost his footing and fell down. Now he continues to press and get back up at the blue line. Misplayed that one, and the Knights go the other way. Knights get up the center. DeBoer has control. Gets it over the blue line. Over on the far left side, DeBoer takes a shot. That was blocked. Rolled off of the stick of Kupelis, and now he comes out of his own zone to the ringette line. Off on the line change is Kinley DeBoer after a solid shift far side. Straight up for the Eagles. They come down across the blue line. Going inside is Pratt. Pratt goes to the left side this time. Look, the trailer was out of his reach for the puck. Now they finally picked it back up, and Kupelis has control of it. Goes deep against the wall. Campbell forced him wide, but it goes right on goal. And a nice glove save by the young man, Max Ryland, as he stops this one from going in. Max Ryland made that big, impressionable stop right there. Faceoff is inside the corner. This time it's over on the left side of young Max Ryland, the goaltender that's playing between the pipes today for the South Delta Knights. From the draw all the way back up to the blue line, kept on side by Kupelis. Now he goes after the second time, got in control of it. Far side, Waits picked it back up over on the far side. Marshall dumped it in this time. Marshall's going to be chasing this one back down. Hettingen goes after his man, trying to get control. Pushed him off of the puck, and they slow to come out of their own zone, but they get out up the center ice. The trailer picks this one back up. Nice play to keep it onside and going deep inside the corner. Chasing it back down. Looks, trying the wraparound. Oh, just rolled wide of the target. Couldn't put a stick on it. Was Dosenberg. And they finally get it back to center. Stopped, going the other way. Marshall goes after that one. Marshall is pushed off of the puck. Waits, looks, back out in front in center ice once again. And Battia throws it straight forward a second time. Marshall goes after it. Marshall's trying to get it loose. Marshall has a little bit of help this time as Pratt comes inside to help him out. Pratt and Marshall, the two of them, try to clear it out, but it goes the other way. Dosenberg comes inside. This time he's over on the right side. Cuts back to the middle part of the ice. Shot, save, right on goal. Huge, impressionable stop right there by Bryson Rebain, and he holds on that one for a well-deserved stoppage of play and a face-off, this time over on the left side of Bryson Rebain. 7 minutes left, third period. After the conclusion of this game, the team will have the medal presentations waiting for it. I think they need an extra player on the ice. They've only got four, but they'll figure it out. They're going to get one more out, I think, right now. Shot right on goal, holding on to that one. The coaching staff finally realized that they've only got four players on the ice, so we have a 5-on-4 situation. Now we get our extra player back on the ice as Marshall steps onto the ice for the Screaming Eagles. Got over in the ringette line on the left side of the ice this time. A couple players fell down, slow to get back up. And it's kept onside once again by the Knights. Off of the backboards, over on the right side this time by Brandon Little, and he goes after his puck. Little comes inside, DeBoer is with him. DeBoer goes after the puck, but it was intercepted by Marshall, who gets it out of his own zone up the center. And Marshall gives it over to Westering. Westering's going to chase it back down inside, but DeBoer picks it up for the Knights, and he throws it on the far left side this time. Across the line as McConnell has control of it. He goes to the front part of the line. waits, looks, couldn't get control of it. Back out in front once again is Dosenberg, clearing it inside the wall. Battia has control, gets it to the blue line area, stopped and kept on side by Komal, and now they go the other way to the blue line. This time it's intercepted. The Knights give the backhand shot, blocked, only went as far as it could. Marshall intercepts this one for the Screaming Eagles and keeps it inside the zone. Marshall is forechecking, as is Westering, two of them trying to get control of the puck as it was really loose for a while there. And they turn and go the other way, all the way up the ice. Komal has control. Komal throws it over, this time to McConnell. And McConnell goes down across the blue line, going inside to try and get control of this one is Hoffman. Hoffman's pinching inside. Buchanan goes after it, throws it against the boards, over on the far left side this time. McConnell stays with him. Lost it, misplayed this one. Easily picked up once again by Stansfield. Stansfield clears it. That's as far as he got it. Now they pick it up back in control of it, and they get it to the blue line area, but that was turning to go the other way. Kept it on side of the blue line. Nice play to keep it on side by the Knights, but that was intercepted. Now the Pratt will go the other way. Pratt gets bumped off of the puck. The two collide. The two of them slow to get back up. Nonetheless, they do get back up. Play carries right on. 4:45 remaining in this third period of play. Clearing it out to the center ice area once again. Buchanan intercepts this one, gives it a backhand shot off of the stick of Dosenberg over in front of the penalty box area. And that was going to be picked up by Alan Crushing, and he goes after that one. Dumped inside the zone. Waits, looks, going after it. We've got an injured player on the ice. No whistle. Now we have the player get up after he was down on the ice for a substantial amount of time. Not sure who the player is, but he is down on the ice. I don't know why one of the coaching staff aren't out on the ice real quick. Now we're seeing the coaching staff come out. Murray Pratt's coming out to him. He gets back up. He's back up and he's down, so we'll watch him very carefully to make sure he is okay. I'm not sure whether he got winded or what. Matthew Allen Crushing is going over to sit down in the players' bench. All the players go down at this level of hockey when someone gets hurt. It's just like watching a football game. If someone does get hurt on the field or on the ice in this level of the game, they all basically go down on one knee just to show a sign of sportsmanship for everybody. So we'll go back. I think we're going to have a face-off outside the blue line in front of the penalty box side in the Screaming Eagles half of the ice. 4 1/4 remaining in this third period of play. Line themselves up for the faceoff. Everyone comes in. The puck is dropped by the game referee. It's just thrown straight forward by Dowler, and Dowler dumps it inside the corner, holding onto it. Looks, throws it straight forward. They're doing a good job forechecking. They're down by a 5-1 margin right now. Slow to come up the other way, but they get across the blue line nonetheless. DeBoer goes inside. DeBoer holds onto that one, waiting for it. Taking his time, and they picked it back up behind the net. Hoffman goes after that one. Hoffman looks, waits, cleared it over the blue line. Far side, give it straight forward to Battia. And Battia couldn't get it out of his zone. Now they finally get it straight up to Stansfield. He gets it up the center ice. Nice play by Stansfield to go straight down over on the left side this time. Coming inside to force him wide was Komal. Stopped, blocked. Eagles doing a good job forechecking to get the puck down the ice and inside the zone. Over on the far side board, stopped by Dowler. He keeps it onside. They're all pushing inside. Going in to help out is Battia, but it was past him and out of his reach. Kupelis trying to take it off of him and did exactly what he succeeded in doing. Back out to center. The Screaming Eagles get control of it across the line. Dowler goes in, careful to stay onside. Taking a shot right on goal. And I think that eluded him. It went right through the pads as the young goaltender, Max Riley, went down to make that stop. But it just surprised everybody and went right between his pads to put them up a 5-2 score right now. They're still trailing by 3, but that was a nice shot right straight down between the young goaltender Ryland's pads. Back out to the center ice area. 3:10 remaining, third period. Referee drops the puck between the players. Chasing it back down is Westering. He throws it over on the far side. Now Westering's going after this one. Couldn't get control of it. Getting it on the far side, this time to Marshall. And Marshall throws it inside the corner, holding on to this one. Pinching inside, stop, turned in the corner is Hedigan. Hedigan cleared it to the blue line area. That's as far as he got, and Kubelis goes inside. Waiting for it, off of the wall, left side this time. They're all pushing for it, trying to get out of the zone right now. The Knights are being hemmed in easily right now by the Screaming Eagles. Trying to get an extra shot right on goal. Big save again by Ryland. And clearly you've got to give the credit right now to the Screaming Eagles. They are supplying an awful lot of pressure in the attacking half of the ice. The coaching staff talking to the players right now. Head coach for the South Delta Knights, Rob Cummel, Kevin Little, Steve Hoffman. The coaching staff, Greg Knobs, Murray Pratt, Greg Dowler, and Alan Marshall are the assistant coaches for the Screaming Eagles. And Leslie Desnoyer is the manager for the Screaming Eagles. I love it when you get all these parents that want to help out, because they do just a great job helping all these young people of today to help them succeed for what the world has to offer them in the world of sports, regardless of how far you might go down the road. Going in across the line over on the far side. Pratt comes in, takes a shot right on goal. Nice stop. Pratt got the shot away this time, and you can see young Ryland going over. And after he got the shot away, Pratt actually gave him a little bit of a tap on the shoulder pad saying, nice stop. I didn't expect that, but he got the shot away. They're having their chances. Looking at it once again, we'll see. Last time I talked to Murray Pratt, Murray told me, he said, good things come when you least expect it. And he said, sometimes we're just a late blooming team. But he said, we come to play and we enjoy ourselves all the time. And that's what it's all about. At the blue line, kept onside, chasing it back down is Jonah Comel. He goes after that one. Picked it back up against the wall, holding onto it. They're trying to clear it back out, and they finally get all the way out to their own zone, up the center ice area, across the line, over on the far left side. Finley McConnell goes after that. Out in front is Kinley DeBurr. McConnell has it, clearing it out to the boards, this time over on the left side. Kept on side as Westering was out of his reach, unfortunately. Now he goes back after it, and if he couldn't do it the first time, he does it a second time. Throws it over. Nice play to get it across ice on the far side. Over to Alan Crushing. He goes straight down. Crushing lost his footing. Gets back up right away and goes back inside the play. Waiting for it, the Screaming Eagles trying to take their man off of the puck, throwing it straight forward inside the zone. Westering goes after it. It's in front of the players' benches. Everybody's pushing, and Westering still in control of the loose puck. Waits. We are in the last minute of play in the third period of play. 5-2. The Knights are leading the Screaming Eagles right now. And the Knights come out of their own zone all the way up the center ice area, across the blue line, going inside. But that was blocked and kept out of the blue line by Buchanan. Now the Knights decided to go the other way. Dumping it inside the zone by DeBurr. He's just going to chase it around, this time over on the right side of the wall. Picked back up behind the net by Kupolis, and he just stops, looks, jamming it in on the short side, jamming it out in front. Shot on the scramble right there, and the Knights get another goal on the board to make it a 6-2 game right there, as they had a tough little bit of tough time clearing it out from at the short side of the net, coming out around the pipe. Young goaltender Bryson Rebane did a good job stopping the first one. We always say the goaltenders can't stop them all. Back out to center, holding onto it, waiting for the draw this time. And we got the draw. And it goes all the way over on the far side. Picked back up. Nice play to get it inside the zone. Chasing it down is Pratt. Pratt goes in, centering pass, jamming at it, going after it right there. They're all scrambling. It's behind the net. Couldn't get control of it. Stansfield comes inside. Young goaltender Ryland lost his stick, had a dive out of the front part of his net to pick it back up. And now they go back the other way. The Knights come straight down across the blue line, bumped off of the puck. Battia takes his man off of the puck. Centering pass, waiting for it. Out in front of the goal, trying to get control of it. And as he got control, got the shot away, the buzzer goes to end the third period. And the game, as the Knights pull off a 6-2 win over the Screaming Eagles in the Adam final party in the house, coming to you from the Ladner Leisure Center. There you can see a happy bunch of boys on the one team, and despite the fact that the players on the opposite end, the Screaming Eagles, might be somewhat dejected, nothing to be ashamed of. They played well. They fought hard. They just had a hard time. Sometimes it just was out of their reach and unable to capitalize on a lot of chances that they had. So we'll watch the players. They will do the traditional handshakes. And while the players do the traditional handshakes, then they will line up and we'll have the medal presentations for the game. As the medal presentations will be made, we'll wait and watch how they all unfold. Want to take this opportunity to thank our game sponsors today, all three game sponsors for the first, second, and third period. First period game sponsor was Lawn Lift. Save the water for drinking and not for sprinkling and paint your lawn. You can get a hold of them. They've got specials on right now. Two bottles for their Ready to Spray for $49.99. You can get a hold of them. And our second period sponsor is brought to you by your Dollar Store for More. Your Dollar Store for More in Tawasin Town Center, serving South Delta community since 2003 and a proud member of South Delta Minor Hockey Association. Our third period sponsor is brought to you by Western Canadian Screens Limited, manufacturers and distributors of wire mesh and perforated plate products. Perfect for design and industrial projects. You can visit them at architecturalwire.com or call them at 604-520-3073. So we'll wait. We'll watch our presentations over on the far side as they're presenting right now. They're making the official presentation to the players over on the far side of the ice. I don't think they have a microphone, so it's a little bit tough for us to listen to as they have, I'm assuming this is going to be the game sponsor for this one. And the game sponsor, according to, well, I would assume that would be maybe the Game Star. I'm trying to listen in. The Game Star for the Knights was Ryan Wiesbrod. And we'll wait and see who the Game Star is for the Screaming Eagles. And I'm looking right now, it's number 14. Miles Dowler gets the luxury of receiving that. So they're passing out right now the medals over on the far side. So I'm assuming we'll have the medals come out. As the players come straight down, we'll watch the players in the medal presentation. So we'll watch the medal presentation. The players go up. Of course, this team that's going over right now are the Screaming Eagles. They'll be going over on the far side. The coaching staff are the Trailers. Of course, you've got the players going through to get it. The coaching staff, Greg Knobs, Murray Pratt, Greg Dowler and Alan Marshall, the assistant coaches for the team. Rob Kummel, Kevin Little, and Steve Hoffman are the coaches for the South Delta Knights squad. So they're still doing the presentations right now for the Screaming Eagles. Players go back out to the blue line area. Set things up, congratulate each other, and the coaches are over there getting their congratulations on the far side right now. So we will wait. Tournament committee passing all the special presentations out to the players. Now they go back, and they were a little bit confused right there. The Screaming Eagles will line up on the blue lines, and now they'll have the presentations for the game winners. The South Delta Knights, who come out and pulled off the victory, led by young goaltender Max Ryland. So they're back out. Once they get the medals, they'll go back to their blue lines. They'll get them all presented. The coaching staff will go back. They've had their traditional handshakes already. And of course, immediately following this game and the Adam Medal ceremony, want to make mention that Imperial Painting wishes to give a shout out to the Adam C. Thunder Wolves. ImperialPainting.ca offers quality and custom interior and exterior paint jobs. Immaculate finishes each and every time. A proud supporter and sponsor of minor hockey. You want stuff for them to do? Let them do the work. ImperialPainting.ca. Presentation still being made over on the far side right now to the players. They're given the traditional handshakes to the tournament committee executive that are passing them out. They're happy. They know what they're getting. Waiting on the far side of the ice for everything to conclude. Players are pleased with their medals that they're actually receiving over there on the far side. This is a medal that, for some, it could be a keepsake. It could be, this could be your Stanley Cup if you decide to end a career here. But for some strange reason, I don't think that's going to happen for some of these young boys that are playing today's game. They want to go on. They want to succeed. They want to see whatever they can do and reach the next level of success. Now we'll get the presentation for these young players at this level. The cup presentation, this is what it's all about right here. We talked about the Stanley Cup moments, and this is for the coaching staff as we'll get the coach walk back over to his team. The players will all come over. This is what it's all about. Success at its highest form right now. The player is getting this. They're thrilled that they have received the cup. And the players, are they going to do a traditional skate around the ice? Sure, this is what they do. They do the traditional skate around the ice. They pass it off to each and every person, as long as no one falls over the sticks that are in the center part of the ice. But they're all going back off. Go around the ice. They're making sure that each player has it for a split second to move it back around. And they'll all take a little bit of time with it, and then they'll go back and regroup. Go to the dressing room, have a little bit of a celebration as they pass it all around. The player is giving it from one player to another, and they're making sure that they all get their turn and they all want to have their moment in history, so to speak, for success. And that's what it's all about for the players at this level of hockey. They come down, they play hard, they fight hard, and they're a happy bunch of boys. You know, you just know that when they go back to school next week, this is going to be the topic of conversation. The coaching staff taking pictures of the boys down in front of their benches, which is really nice to see, and that's what it's all about. They're passing the cup around from player to player to player, and they're all getting their turn at it as they're going to go back out. And I think they're all going to line themselves up for a shot, maybe a photo op session for the coaching staff. Going to line themselves up, so we'll wait till they line themselves up. All going to make sure they're in the picture. That was a well-played game, despite the fact that it was a 6-2 final. You have to give an awful lot of credit. The Knights and the Screaming Eagles, both of them played hard. They fought hard. The Knights come out victorious by a 6-2 margin right now. And the coaching staff for the boys on the ice lining themselves up for the traditional handshake for this Adam Division final championship game for the 2015 South Delta Minor Hockey Party in the House. Or as they call it, the Party in the House. Hope you've enjoyed the broadcast for today's game. We've got three more games that we are doing from the Ladner Leisure Center. If you're unable to watch this online, come on down to the Ladner Leisure Center and take it in. Or send me a note on Twitter, which is just at Sportswave, and let us know that you're watching it and where you're watching these games from, and we'll give you a special shout out. So as the players look at getting their sticks and gloves and go to the dressing room, we're going to take a timeout and come back, take a bit of a rest. The ice will get resurfaced, and we'll come back with the call for the Pee Wee Party in the House final championship game up next on Sportswave Productions from the Ladner Leisure Center.